space. Something we can't seem to be able to get around here. These are the adventures of a bunch of actors trapped in an amusement park. Their five-year mission, to find a way out without getting caught in real time, to seek out strange new life forms. Very strange new life forms. They were weird.
Weird?
Weird?
Yeah, I guess that is the word for it.
Weird.
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 To boldly go where no man has gone before. Or maybe not.
Huh? Oh, no.
No, no, they're doing it clown style. No.
And Madonna thinks she's innovative.
Please tell me this isn't happening. Oh, no.
No.
More. I'm a bad clown.
Yes, children's windows of perception are open for only a second, only to take in the horror that is...
State America.
And here come the freaks now!
Iedereen is gek hier.
Yes, I was one of the zombies.
What a pity. Human.
Hey, we're the aliens. We frighten everyone we see. We're the fake generation, and we got something to say.
Oh, shit.
A renegade Klingon vessel. Bent on the destruction of the new Klingon Federation Alliance has succeeded in following us back through time. And unfortunately has managed to destroy the USS Stockwood. Fortunately, however, Admiral Ward and his team specialists managed to escape. Unfortunately, they allowed Caleb to drive, and so he crashed.
Caleb?
Sobek!
What are you doing?
Nothing, Sobek.
I just think you saw you trying to break with another
movie. I was not breaking into it, you see, I was shutting it. I was afraid someone would try to get. I was trying to break into it, Sobek.
Why? What purpose? We haven't given automobile, we have shuttlecraft transporters.
I crashed the shuttlecraft!
Our last shuttlecraft?
I was coming in for a landing, and Midge then was navigating. This
was Midge's fault, I see.
It was all Midge's fault! Go back! Yes?
Tell me you fixed the transporter this morning.
Okay, I fixed the transporter this morning.
We have no communicators.
Yes.
We have no transporters. And no shuttlecraft.
Please, Sobek! What
do you know what this means, Caleb?
That I should break into this car.
This means that we're going to have to live at this wretched amusement park. I have regained my control.
All right.
I have a decline. Yes, I'm all right. Good help. It's so hard to find these days.
log supplemental.
Oh, my God.
Admiral Ward has suddenly been found missing.
Oh, humanity.
If I had emotions, I would be quite upset right now.
Oh.
But I don't, so. We'd better go looking for him immediately. Let's split up. Captain's log, supplemental. We're going to make a second attempt to search for Admiral Ward. Some of us will search in groups. However, others of us will search independently.
I'm going to infiltrate the Frangi Society and see what happened to Admiral Ward. I'll interrogate those little small beings and make them tell me the truth, or they'll find their ears elongated even more.
Gah. And so, having failed with infiltrating the Ferengi culture, Trevor decided to go off and get drunk and sing the flauta for about 2 or 3 weeks. To infiltrate the Ferengi culture to find out what information she could about Admiral Ward, Tegra decided to pose as popular singer Cher in a Ferengi nightclub.
She helps his triumph fancy. We hear it from the people of the town. They call us gypsies, tramps, and thieves. But every night all the men would come around and lay their money down.
Unfortunately, she forgot that Cher had an extremely smooth forehead, just like a Terran's baby bottom. She was rejected, and so she decided to go off and drink and sing Malota with Trevor.
I decided to go to the Klingon priest to seek his insight. Excuse me, Garak, but do you know how we can find Admiral Ward?
Sovek, opportunities seldom drop in your lap. You have to create them yourself. And yet, you have to be patient to wait for the proper opportunity to arise before you take action. You see, if a being lives, it is a certainty they are going to die. Therefore, to look upon death as an enemy, a foe that is needing to be vanquished, is the act of a fool.
I found this special wisdom to be both profound and insightful, and it had absolutely nothing to do with what I was talking about.
I'm sorry, we have to take preliminary measures. And there's just no other way. Sometimes you have to be the bad guy.
By daytime, she's a not-so-mild-mannered female Klingon warrior. But when danger rears its ugly head, or it becomes lunchtime, she becomes... Wonder Tegras! Wonder Tegras! Wonder Tegra, Wonder Tegra. No one knows what you will do, or the powers you possess. In your Klingon tight, fighting those damn lights, she'll save the world and destroy it too.
You know, I think I fully recovered from the Cardassian occupation of my planet. I'm getting over it.
Snitch, we have a communique from Bajor for you.
Oh, all right. Thank you.
Hmm.
up the hill, promise to. They have further created voice from him, his piece, a hat. Rebels was my only friend for 6 years, and they killed him and made a hat out of him.
Here you go. All right, we realize it's not quite as you originally got it. Wonder Bill, da da da.
He thinks the public needs it.
You're not the real superhero. You don't even have an actual theme song.
I don't have time for songs. I'm busy saving people.
Saving people? Like who?
We suspected the Romulan of being in cohorts, being evil, doing something to Admiral Ward. However, we discovered after a while that he was just terribly weird. And so we went away.
How many Romulan warbirds do we have?
We have one.
All right, how many does the Empire have?
200, I imagine.
All right, where are they?
They're all in the 24th century.
Kosher, how soon can they be here?
Well, they can't.
Why not?
Because there's no way I can contact them. Come on, Tavor, be real.
We have a transmitter. I've seen you use it before to talk to the planets, huh?
Uh-huh, okay. And you want me to get all 200 warbirds time travel ready in here?
Yes.
Today?
Yes.
Why?
Just the mistake, the meeting I went to a little while ago.
The meeting with the Nazis?
Yes.
What
happened? Well, with the political disagreements, cultural, social disagreements.
What did you say?
Jay, the conversation was going a certain direction. Things were said that probably shouldn't have been. I mentioned something about his mother.
Something about his mother? To an Oscan, the only species that has a chance of beating us in a war?
Yes.
And now you want all 200 warbirds here?
Yes.
Because they want to go to war with us?
Well, with me specifically.
With you?
Yes.
Well, then we don't have a problem, do we?
Wait, you can't mean that.
You'll go back and deal with this yourself.
You'll play me.
Or you'll deal with me.
All right, I'll deal with the Nazgans.
Off you go. That's right.
I remember this, go back.
Yes, blow it out your ears.
And so Tavork went to face his destiny, fighting the agent that the Nausicaans hired at the very last minute on the side. Tavork won his battle against the Nausican agent by default. Evidently, the Nausican agent had a severe case of asthma. Unfortunately, Kavek left him behind, taking the shuttle back to the 24th century.
Kavek!
Once Commander Sovek's out of the way, the mission is mine. All right, Sovek, I regret to inform you there's going to be some changes around here.
Oh?
Yes, with you out of the way, it seems the mission would be mine as the only guiding officer on this mission. So, consider this early retirement. Goodbye.
Hey, Bob.
That was interesting, husband.
Indeed.
I always thought that those Romulans were dogs anyway.
Hello, everyone. Jim.
Excuse me, can I
of course.
What do you want?
You know, it's just something I've always wanted to tell you.
No.
But what is your commander?
No.
Ask your back.
Commander.
No, Commander.
Commander.
Quebec. Please, call me Quebec.
This is very personal. I don't want you to think of me as exercising my power over you, all right?
I've never really liked you. No, I mean, you do a fine job down there in sick bay or wherever it is you were, man.
Oh, sure.
Something I've really put my finger on either. Take her off here. She's not in the slightest bit dishonest. I mean, ugly. I don't know why I'm telling you all this. Who is this Quebec? I'm the commander of this ship. Get off my bridge. That's right. Go. You heard me.
Yes.
Is it hot in here?
I'm hot.
Are you hot?
Undaunted, Garlock began staring into flames. But regulations prevented him from having an open flame, so he had to settle for staring into a flashlight. It didn't work. He began seeking visions elsewhere.
He sought visions everywhere. And I mean everywhere. He sought visions in places that men were meant to simply not seek visions in.
Garlock was seeking for a vision in the bottom of his 10th goblet of Klingon bloodline. And just as he was about to give up, the vision he had so desperately been searching for came to him, inspired by Trebor's opera.
Shrek,
I know the truth about Slurk, that he is responsible for what happened to Admiral Ward. I want you to tell me all that you know.
Oh, I really don't have anything worth telling. I mean, besides...
Shrek, don't make me kill you again.
Well, you could kill me, but then you still wouldn't know, would you? You know, there's nothing you could do that could make me betray Slurk, because he's my...
You forgotten
him? Yeah, sure. Well, you see, he's got this power with women, that's the deal.
We're going to have you tell this to Commander Sobek.
Okay, do I get more latinum?
Shut up! Don't push it. Sobek, here is this. I have discovered the mystery behind the disappearance of Admiral Ward. Shrek here has information. Go on, tell him.
Yeah, well, you see, Slurk, he's got...
Tell him how Slurk is responsible for the disappearance of Admiral Ward.
That's what I was just going to say. See, Slurk, he's
tell him how he has this strange power.
Yeah, he's got this power over women.
Go on, tell him about it. Tell me.
Well, yeah, see, he's got this power over women. They just can't resist him. All women. All of them.
But it doesn't make my wife your mother.
Shrek, you must be in touch. I sense nothing unusual coming from Slurk.
Well, you see, Slurk's secret is, he got the thing, Now, you get the idea? Go on.
I understand. Sobek, I will be leaving you for Slurk. Goodbye.
Yes, I am Vulcan from the planet Sobek. Sobek from the planet Vulcan. Is it hot in here? I'm terribly hot. You know, this morning I got a comm call from Commander Quebec. Quebec called me and he said, why don't you beam over to my starship and I'll make you some breakfast. And so I said, sure. You know, us two people have never handled a very good never been very good friends. Quebec had this big pot of tea waiting for me. It was very good. Quebec, he was so nice that he didn't drink any at all himself. He let me have it all. You don't suppose that Quebec did something to the tea of him? I don't think sick day, I.
Wait a moment. Come here.
Lieutenant Commander Caleb. Commander Sobek has gone insane after the loss of his wife, Tifana. He has run around the ship in a drunken stupor. He tried to break into my cabin and have his way with me. He tried to marry me so that he could have his way with me, and I broke it off right after the honeymoon. In fact, it seems that everyone here has gone insane. Except for me, of course. Tariq, I want you. Tariq, can I keep this one? Come here.
Get the hell away from me. Get the hell away from me.
We'll be right back.
Life forms for your recreation.
What did you expect in an opera? A happy ending?
You learned almost too late that man is a feeling creature. And because of it, the greatest in the universe. And you learned too late for himself that men have to find their own way to make their own mistakes. There can't be any gift of perfection from outside ourselves. And when men seek such perfection, find only death, fire, loss, disillusionment, and the end of everything that's gone forward. Men have always sought an end through toil and misery. And it can't be given, it has to be achieved. There is hope, but it has to come from inside, from man himself.